Very good job, Megan. Your form is much improved. Okay, Bianca, now it's your turn.
That's okay. I need to check out my computer.
Don't be nervous.
It's not that. I just remembered. It's time for the movie surfers. Should I go get her?
She'll come when she's ready.
Hi, Tina. It's Bianca.
Hi, Bianca. You okay? You sound a little out of breath.
I'm fine. I was just practicing my martial arts.
Really? Well, then you're in the right mindset to check out Disney's new animated feature film, Mulan. It's got plenty of great fight scenes.
Great.
Who else is out there?
It's Drew. I'm all set, and I invited my friend Bernie to join the surfers.
What's up, Drew? Thought we were gonna go skateboarding.
Well, first we surf, then we skate. Right, Tina?
Who are you talking to?
The movie surfers. I'm Tina.
Whoa.
Welcome aboard, Bernie. You'll get the hang of it.
Hey, guys, it's Matt in the studio. Any other surfers out there?
Hey there, it's Tom. Where's Chris?
Present and accounted for. Let's go.
Hey, surfers. Welcome to the world of Disney's Mulan. Today, we'll find out how Disney brought all the characters of this famous Chinese legend to life.
Fulfill your duties calmly and respectfully. This shall bring you honor and glory.
Hey!
And meet the actors, including Pat Morita.
I have heard a great deal about you, Fa Mulan.
Who provides the commanding voice of the Emperor.
Pat Morita here.
Later, we're going to the Movie Surfer Studio. Right, Matt?
You bet. Today, I'm making colorful Chinese lanterns, and you can too.
And remember to look up for our trivia quiz. So don't surf away. It's gonna be a knockdown, drag-out good time. Everyone ready?
I'm ready.
All set here. I guess I'm ready.
Mouse in position.
Everyone clicks on my cue. 3, 2, 1.
We are counting on you to
uphold the family honor.
Mulan tells a story of an extraordinary young woman in ancient China.
I'm here.
She fears she will never become a traditional bride and bring honor to her family. But everything changes for Mulan when the Huns invade China.
We're under attack! Light the signal!
By order of the emperor, one man from every family must serve in the imperial army.
Father, you can't go.
Mulan.
Please, sir. My father has already fought for
silence! England.
To protect your injured father, Mulan breaks with tradition and disguises herself as a soldier to join the troops. But she doesn't go to battle alone. Mulan is joined by Mushu and Kriki.
My ancestor sent a little lizard to help me.
Hey, dragon, not lizard. I don't do that tongue thing.
So Mulan risks her life and her family's honor to fight the ruthless Shan Yu and his army of evil Huns.
Nice avoiding the flip, Bianca.
Huh?
You know, you're gonna have to learn it if you want your next belt.
I know. But first, I want to see how they created Mulan.
Who's Mulan?
Click the Focus On icon to find out.
Hi, movie surfers. My name is Mark Hinn, and I did the drawings for Mulan.
Unlike any of the characters that I've done, Mulan is not only herself, but she then has to become this other character.
Time to show him your man walk. Shoulders back, chest high, feet apart, head up, and strut.
So you've got the initial challenge of creating a new character. Then on top of that now, she goes off and dresses up like a guy.
Now remember, it's your first day of training, so now let's see your war face. But come on, scare me, girl! Yeah, that's my tough-looking warrior. That's what I'm talking about. Now get out there and make me proud.
Actress Ming-Na Wen was the speaking voice for Mulan.
I'm here!
It isn't so much sitting there and sketching as much as I enjoyed observing what Ming-Na does.
I read the segments of script that they give me, and I talk to the directors.
Yeah, let's add a little something on the front of it.
Okay. Yeah, that helps, that little handle.
When I'm voicing the part of Mulan as Mulan the girl, and voicing the part of Mulan as the boy, it's still the same character. The only thing that I change is the pitch rather than the personality.
I don't need anyone causing trouble in my camp.
Sorry. Sorry you had to see that.
Now I see
Leia Salonga provided the singing voice for Mulan.
Mulan is this young girl. She's no weakling. She's somebody who will take matters into her own hands and do what she has to do to make things right.
Hey, guys! I've got an idea.
In terms of the voice, the orchestra will set the mood for the songs that I'm doing. And that sort of just carries you off to another place. And once you're, like, singing with these 80 pieces that are all just somehow gelling together as one massive unit, people don't understand the high that you get. It's nirvana.
When will my reflection show who I am inside?
Pretty impressive.
Click the script to screen icon to find out how the Disney artist transformed the ancient Chinese legend into the movie.
Oh, allow me.
The journey of Mulan as a story into a film is an extraordinary long journey. It actually begins 2,000 years ago when the great legend itself first came to existence in China.
For a long time we've been marching off to battle.
We've never done a movie that deals with Asian characters, Chinese art. And the idea of going to research that, figuring out how to make designs work, how to make the backgrounds work, was a great challenge, and Hans Bacher really worked diligently to try and recreate a sense of what we felt was appropriate for this movie.
Hans Bacher was the production designer for Mulan.
What does a production designer do?
He's the person responsible for designing the look of the film.
Chinese artwork is very flat. They don't use perspective. They concentrate more on information about where something takes place, not that much about the characters. It's just about their beautiful landscape. We had a group of artists, they went to China and did thousands of photographs, so we have enough reference for our film for the design. It's one of the best films I ever worked on. It's beautiful.
Come on, Bianca, it's your turn on the mat.
I'm still surfing, Megan.
But Mr. Brooks can't stay too long.
But I want to see the martial arts in Mulan.
Hey, Tina. How'd they make the characters look like they were really fighting?
The animators worked with a fight advisor to get it right. Click the icon to learn more about it.
No matter how the wind howls, a mountain cannot bow to it. Then you will kneel in pieces.
It's hard to make up authentic-looking kung fu moves from scratch if you don't really know martial arts. You can't fake it. B.H. Barry came out as an advisor on staging some of the fight scenes, and he definitely helped us think through some of the action sequences.
Important thing for you is do not react until after I've hit you.
Gotcha. Yeah, oh, serious stomach pains.
That can't be real.
Don't worry, B.H. Barry taught animators like Ruben Aquino how actors throw fake punches.
How we cheat this is we use the fist, and then it becomes a hand, then comes back to a fist again. And because the hand moves so fast, you don't see it. The training session that we did worked out very well. Uppercut. Good. You could see how the animator took over from the idea. It gave him a springboard.
Shang, go!
Mulan's got some really tough moves.
Yeah, she's pretty good for a girl.
You're a caveman. Girls can be fighters, too.
Busted.
Well,
Hey, guys. Eddie Murphy did the voice of Mulan's dragon pal, Mushu. Click on the snapshot icon if you're feeling strong enough, Drew.
Very funny.
Who are you?
I am the powerful, the pleasurable, the indestructible Mushu.
Oh, pretty high, huh?
Mushu is sort of the comic sidekick to Mulan. But of course, being the comic sidekick, he gets her into more trouble than anything.
Did you see those Huns? They popped out of the snow, like daisies.
Are we in this together or not?
Well, let's go kick some honey buns.
does kind of have sort of his own interior motives. He wants Mulan to succeed, because then if she succeeds, then he gets all the honor and glory.
In Chinese mythology, there are dragons. Our version of the dragon was really to find a good voice and to make sort of a new character, a fresh character out of it.
Jump back, I'm pretty hot, huh?
Something that'd be very funny and provide a lot of the comic relief in the story, because there's so many serious moments in the story. You need a character that can provide that humor.
It was a lot of fun because Eddie Murphy did some great dialogue, did some great readings. I just sat off to the side as he was recording and just did sketches of him, different facial expressions. It was very inspiring.
You're,
intimidating?
Awe-inspiring?
Tiny.
Of course. I'm travel size for your convenience. If I was my real size, your cow here would die of fright. Down, Bessie.
I can't wait to see Mushu on the big screen.
Does Mushu mean dragon in Chinese? I think it's a kind of food.
That's right, Tom. It's a Chinese dish, kind of like a soft taco. Hey, guys, it's a trivia icon. Ready to play?
Player number one here.
Other player number one here. Mushu is the name of the dragon in Mulan. Can you name the animated dragon in the movie Pete's Dragon?
That's a hard one. Is it Baloo?
Nope. Baloo is the bear from The Jungle Book. The dragon from Pete's Dragon was named Elliot.
You are good. Here's another one. The woman who provided the singing voice of Mulan is also the voice of what other Disney animated heroine?
That's easy. Belle in Beauty and the Beast.
No, she was Meg from Hercules.
You're both wrong. Leia Salonga was the singing voice for Princess Jasmine in Aladdin.
All right, this one's mine. Pat Morita, who's the voice of the Emperor in Mulan, is famous for another movie featuring martial arts. Can you name it?
I know. He was Mr. Miyagi in The Karate Kid.
Hey, didn't Tina say she was meeting Pat Morita in the chat box?
We're there.
Hey, surfers. Pat Morita here. Come on, give me some questions. I'm anxious to hear from you.
What do I do?
Just ask a question.
How do you work with the animators to create the character?
In the beginning, they sort of brought a lot of the principal actors in, and the animators were sort of off to one side, absorbing people's facial characteristics or their little quirks. And they'd be taking their notes and this and that, while we listened to our director and creative people giving us general directions. And these are the things that help make the animated work or the final results in the movies that you get to see.
How did you make your voice sound like an emperor?
I sort of kind of found his voice when he had to address this wonderful young lady and accusingly almost say to her, "You dishonored the Chinese army, destroyed my palace, and you have saved us all. One day, the entire world will know about you, Mulan."
How did you get into performing?
You have to learn to develop your talent. You have to learn to have a little luck on your side. You have to learn to grow in life, you know. But basically, my philosophy is, you want to learn how to become an actor, learn to read. And I don't mean just read stuff that's assigned to you in schools. I'm talking about develop a curiosity that makes you read a variety of things.
Sounds like good advice, Pat. And thanks for stopping by the chat box.
Catch you later.
Bianca, are you ready?
Not quite.
Fine. But remember, you have to learn a shoulder throw before we leave.
No problem.
Come on, Bianca. We're finding out how the animators use sculptures to draw the characters from different angles.
I'm there.
My name is Tony Cipriano, and I do the sculptures, the maquettes.
What's a maquette?
It's a clay model of the character, based on the animator's drawings.
They're a tool for the animators to see their characters from different perspectives. For example, if an animator has a scene which calls for like a worm's eye view,
boo,
or an upshot, he can just take the maquette and hold it up and actually draw the maquette.
These are the maquettes that we get. They're basically just a three-dimensional reference for when you get weird angles that might be a little difficult to draw out of your head. It's there so you can go, oh, okay, that's how you do it.
This is Sean Yu, he's the villain. He was probably the most fun to work on. On my own, I like to do like creatures and monsters and stuff like that. And this is about the closest thing to a monster on this film anyway.
Perfect.
what the maquette enables all of us to see is the consistency within the character as far as his mass, his features, proportions.
Shan Yu.
Nice work, gentlemen.
I should have prayed to the ancestors for luck.
How lucky can they be? They're dead. Besides, I've got all the luck we'll need.
Without a doubt, this was the hardest one. The cricket, basically his legs and his antenna are just one line. So I just had to use a wire. And these little hairs off the back of his legs were just little wires glued on.
This is your chance to prove yourself.
So what's next?
Slow down, you're gonna sprain your clicking finger.
Bianca, don't you want to try the flip? It's the only way they'll let you advance.
It's just a bell.
It's more than that. It's part of ancient Chinese culture. Are you afraid?
No, it's just that Matt's in the surfer studio making Chinese lanterns. That's part of ancient culture too.
Hi guys, it's Matt. Welcome to the studio. Today we're making our own Chinese paper lanterns you can use to decorate your room. First, fold a piece of cardstock in half. Then take a bowl from the kitchen and trace a semicircle on the card. Draw two ears like this on either side. Then
have your mom or dad cut out the shape and unfold it.
Next, take 50 sheets of tissue that are bigger than your template. Not the kind of tissue you blow into, but tissue paper you can buy in an art supply store. In groups of 10, place them under your template. Trace them with a pencil, and cut them out to match. You'll need a good pair of scissors and a whole lot of patience to finish all 50 sheets. I'm done. Now, lay the tissues on your template and staple the ends, creating a spine. Next, take a glue stick and glue the bottom piece to the card template. Then, glue along the edge of the tissue, leaving small dabs of glue about an inch apart. Stick the next tissue down to it. Then, glue stick the edge of that piece down, dabbing in between the places where you glued the previous piece. You can see where you glued through the tissue. Press that down and keep repeating the process until all the sheets are done. I finished this one earlier. Bring the cardboard ends together all the way around, completing the ball. And paper clip it together. I made a few earlier today to give you the full effect. Hit it! All set for a party. You can make them in lots of colors and add tassels for decorations. Good luck, surfers.
Bianca, I know you can do this.
I'd rather make a lantern.
If you just put your mind to it.
I can't.
Why not?
He's too big.
What do you think Mulan would do if she were in your shoes?
I guess she would use mind over matter and go after a goal.
So what are you waiting for?
Are you ready?
I think so. Mr. Brooks?
Oh no, what did you do?
I told you this wasn't a good idea. Very funny. Hey, I did it.
Congratulations.
Can I try it again?
Relax, Bianca. Remember, the martial arts are to be used for defense only.
Not even on Megan?
Especially not on Megan.
The movie Surfers.
You're just in time, surfers. We're about to meet composer Matthew Wilder, who worked with some great musical performers.
We've had some amazing moments in the recording studio.
We must be swift as a coursing river.
Donny Osmond, he is one of the hardest working perfectionists that I've ever worked with.
The main thing was to be intense. Because I am not Donny Osmond singing this, I am Shang.
Mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
Harvey Fierstein plays one of the characters, and he's very, very colorful.
For a long time we've been marching all to battle. In a thundering herd, we feel a lot like cattle.
There are no promises. And the way I sing, they shouldn't be making any promises.
The sound is just monumental. It's very exhilarating.
The greatest gift and honor is having you for a daughter.
It's been fun meeting some of the talented people who brought Mulan to life. Let's sign off with music legends Stevie Wonder and 98 Degrees singing the final song for Mulan, Be True to Your Heart.
When things are getting crazy and you don't know where to start, keep on believing, baby, just be true to your heart.
Take it, Cricky! Call out for egg rolls!
See you next time, if I ever get the mouse back from Bernie.
Hey, I'm into this. Later.
Who did a good job?
I'll see you at the movie, surfers.
Surf on.
Later, surfers.
You the man. Well, sort of.
Bye, movie surfers.
Goodbye, movie surfers.
Take care, everyone.
Ching Song Idiot.
That was Chinese for goodbye.
Now that's what I call Mongolian barbecue.
Bye-bye, surfers.
That little baby is all grown up and saving China.